feel free to throw it at me. Otherwise, we're going to get straight into it. Okay? We did Busan yesterday, last week. We might do a little bit more of that. But definitely always cleaning ourselves up. Okay? Any questions from last week? Okay. Great. Glad you're staying safe and promoting health through your movement, working on your accuracy and your position. I've been watching our tapes. You've been looking good, but always looking for ways to refine and get better. Okay. You don't want to be complacent and be happy with what you're doing. You always want to look and critique yourself, and that way you can work on being better, right? I don't want to be too relaxed on that. Now, we're going to get started. I'd like to start up a salute, and then we'll start off with exercises with the shoulders. Thank you so much for being here. All right, let me just get a screenshot for attendance. Wait on Pierre. All right. Appreciate you for being here. Thank you so much for making time out of your valuable time to spend it with me and to train. Okay? Salama Pro. Let's do it. Start off with blading our bodies, shoulder exercises, aiming your shoulder at the ball. No deflection yet. No hitting it yet. All evasion, all parry, okay? So it could look like this. You're gonna, this angle, parry angle, really sharp, really thin, right? No footwork. There's no footwork right now, okay? No footwork. Okay, follow it with your eyes. Okay, just be square on it. Square the ball. But I do want you to move hips and knees and shifting the weight by moving the balls of your feet, okay? Just because you're not moving, you're not taking in steps, doesn't mean you don't invite your hips, your knees, and your ankles in the movement. Excellent, Mateo. Right? Don't disrupt the center line. Allow the center line to take its course. Hola. Hi, baby.
Kiki, bonjour.
Bonjour.
Oh, hi, baby.
How old is it?
Okay, shoulders. Shoulders only, no elbows, okay?
Sorry. Allô?
Hey, this time we're gonna slip around it. We're gonna slip around it. Like this. Slip. Go around. Slip, let it go around. Slip, let it go around. Now, what I'd like you to do as it goes around is align your right shoulder or the shoulder that's coming around. Align it as it goes around. Nice, Trisha. Nice, Bautista. Excellent. Right? And then once you get used to that side, go do the other side. Right? Try to make the pendulum ball swing linear instead of circular. Okay? Nice, Joe. Nice, Joe. But this time, less ducking, more swiveling, right, of the upper body. But the ducking is important, right? Nice, that's the one, that's the one. Nice, nice and fine. It's really thin, really fine like that, Joe. But as it gets around to the other shoulder, I want you to align the other shoulder when it gets around. Follow it with the other shoulder, okay? Yeah, good. So, but if it hits you, that's okay. But that represents a strike. That means you got hit, okay? So try not to get hit. Try not to let the ball hit you, Excellent, Joe. Following it with your shoulders all the way in, all the way out. Excellent. All right, now add the footwork. Move around with it, okay? Same concept, upper body. Footwork. Follow it now. Now you can follow it. When it goes away from you, follow it with your shoulder. Follow it with your shoulder. Remember, cover up your chin. Cover up your chin with the other hand. I'm going to mute folks. If you have a question, turn on your microphone. Otherwise, I'm muting people. Thank you so much. Nice, Mateo. Okay, Joe, keep going. I'd like everybody to take a few a minute break. I want everybody to take a look at Joe. Joe, keep going. No, you got it. Come on. Come on. Please, please. I'll let you pass. Yeah. Yeah. Please. Okay. So what I like about this is even though that she's going really slow, which I want, right, her eyeballs are focused on it, right? And as soon as she as soon as it goes around her, she's anticipating where it's coming, and she aligns it with her other shoulder, right? Nice. You see that little shoulder, little shake and bake she did? I like that. Feel free to follow it, okay? Excellent. Get back to work. Good job, Joe. Keep it up. Okay, now add elbows. Now we're going to add the second point, the elbows, okay? Try to make it come for this part, and then later you could do other angles, but try to make everything come from 6 o'clock for now, okay? 6 o'clock. Going up and down for now. And then we'll add circular and horizontal elbows. But for now, 6 o'clock elbows going upwards only. And don't lose the shoulders. Bring the shoulders in. Okay, I'm gonna go around the room. Okay, Pierre, you can also start doing footwork now, right? Pierre, you can start moving your feet, right? Excellent. Okay, graduate is joining us. Okay, graduate. Maxwell. What's up, Queer Maxwell? Thanks for coming. Once again, happy graduation. Thank you for being here. Congratulations. We're working on evasion, no contact with the ball. We are aligning our shoulders. It was the first 5 minutes. Now we're aligning our elbows and our shoulders. No contact, just specific like pinpoint accuracy, okay? Okay, so Guru Trish has now added elbows, so I think it's a good time. Actually, while we're at it, Guru Trish, if you could just keep going. I'm gonna ask everybody to take a quick 1 minute break and look at Guru Trish's screen. Break time. Observation, Pierre, can you come take a look right quick? So what we're looking at here is, wait. Okay. So she's slipping through, right? And she's inserted other thick kinds of elbows, right? Right now she's doing 6 o'clock. There is a 12 o'clock one going downward. All right. And that's when, that way she can use her elbow. See that? How she used her elbow to dive into the new angle. Okay? So I'd like you guys, see there was a double, triple elbow there. You can do more than one elbow. All right? Excellent job, Trish. All right? Hyper focus on the ball. So I'm going to add on. Thank you, Guru Trish. Amazing job. I'm going to add on right quick. One, two. I'm hitting the ball twice as it comes at me in the quarter, in the square dots of the bubble. One, two. I'm swimming. I'm going 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock. But you see, when I do the 12 o'clock, just like the 6 o'clock where all my shoulders are aligned, right? I'm not square like this. I'm in a line, right? Same with the 12 o'clock. Look how I turn. Look at my thumb pointing down. Thumb points down, right? When the thumb points down, this whole part of my elbow opens up. And then that's what comes in. And then when it comes in, see how my shoulder follows? And this snakes, and then this follows. So it's aligned, right? So it's gonna look weird. You're gonna feel pretty uncomfortable, but it's okay because you're gonna get used to it, right? But the way you do it, make it successful, is you thumb down and slide it in, slip it in, right? Like you're reaching in the, you left your keys in the car, and the car has, you left your keys inside the car in the ignition, and it has like that window opening, right? So what you wanna do is slide it in, elbows pointed down, okay? So two shots. If you're gonna do it, one, two, right? You could feel free to mix it up. Go 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Or 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock, right? But small swimming moves, small circular moves. That's the only way you're gonna accomplish two strikes if you make them small and circular, right? So don't just hit it, boom, boom. Hit, and then bring it back to the other hit, okay? Good luck. I'm gonna go around the room and check everybody out. Mateo is killing his ball. As always. Nice, Dimitri. Nice accuracy, Dimitri. Yeah. Oh, love that one. Backwards 6 o'clock shot. Oh, nice, Dimitri. At the point of the tip of your elbow, okay? The tip of the elbow, good job. Yeah, it's hard to execute that 12 o'clock. Nice, Trish. Yeah, just work on that. Yeah. And for you to feel even more comfortable when you deploy that, Trish, is when you do deploy the 12 o'clock elbow, shoot your shoulder too, right? Yeah, right? And then this hand, your hand is gonna go in the middle of your body. You're gonna suck it in. Yeah, suck it in tight to your stomach. Nice, that one. Yeah. It's a sharp, small circle. Good job, Trish. Nice, Joe. Nice, Joe. Yeah. Oh, okay. Nice one. I love how you're throwing your shoulders as part of it. It's like your elbows and your shoulders. Excellent. So Joe, when you do drop those elbows, right? You try to like make it extend forward a little bit, right? And that's weird because like for me, I'm a shorter person, right? And remember pointing it try to point it downwards, going downwards, yeah? Which means you gotta kind of like engage your shoulder, and then I kind of like do this, like I kind of close in, right? And this hand goes into the middle of my body, right? Right? Yep, yep, nice. Yeah, and then shoot that accurately at the tip of the target, right? So now you're gonna do this. Yeah. You know, you could even just do, just even right now, maybe you just work on throwing 12 o'clocks. Stay in a space, right? And just be like, boom, boom, boom. Working on your 12 o'clocks, right? 12 o'clock. So the 6 o'clock and the 12 o'clock elbow, guys, is hard to see. People are going to have a hard time seeing it because it's straight. It's a straight punch, but it's a straight elbow. Excellent, Pierre. Nice, Pierre. Yes. Remember to cover your chin. Nice. Nice. Nice, Pierre. Okay, keep going, Dimitri. Everybody take a quick break and take a look at Dimitri's screen. Dimitri, keep going. Okay. So Dimitri, look how I am. He's in a doorway, right? So he's kind of limited in the space. But because this exercise is about the elbows, he can move around it, right? And then, so look at how his feet adjusts to the pendulum. As the ball goes farther away, then he hops towards it. I mean, not hop, but he kind of climbs there, right? He kind of goes towards that area, okay? Excellent. There's some back elbows, right, that he's throwing in there, right? So that's, you can really work it at a small space with when you're doing elbow exercise. That one I kind of like, that 6 o'clock, but reverse. It's a 6 o'clock, but it's going upward, you know, it's going like this, you know, that's tight. That's hard to see. That's hard to see. Now, what I'd like you to do when you do that is try to make it from six. I know, because what's happening is we have tight elbows, shoulders, right? But when Maestro Sunny did this, he was so flexible. Thank you so much, Dimitri, good job. He was so flexible that this looked like at 6 o'clock. Right now, because we haven't really done this exercise, our 6 o'clock look like it's coming from here, still wide, right? But really, make the 6 and the 12 o'clock elbows come from your center. Come from the center. And the way you do that, that's gonna take time, right? But one way I did that with Master Sunny is this. Come look. We would, he would get us to a wall. He said, go to a wall, Jay, right? And then, so he asked us to go to a wall, right? Or this wall, right? We'll do this wall. And he had us practice the elbow drop to make sure that we were parallel with the wall. So we weren't like bumping it. We weren't like, right? It was like parallel. So let me see if I can do a better, maybe here. Let me change this angle. It's my door, right? Right? So when we saw this, the door is right in the middle of my face, right? He'll have us do this exercise, right? Or we'll be right next to the wall. Right? And that way we were practicing how to drop these 12 o'clock elbows, and it was harder for you to see because it's dropping towards the center instead of, right? Okay? So that's why you could be at home working on these elbows and be a parallel to the wall. So your movement can be more parallel to the line, to the center line, right? The center line is this. This is the center line. I get punched. The person is right in front of me, right? Right? So then when I'm striking, I'm out of the way, or if I'm striking directly at the target, I'm trying to let that come right at the middle. Right? So it's really like this is going inside the middle of my chest, right? And sometimes what I do is I'll put my hand up. I'll put my hand up and then I'll put my thumb down. All right, so include the 12 and try to really come let, so it's harder to see. So your opponent's like, what the hell? He's throwing an elbow at me. All right, so include that now, and then we'll move on to the next thing with weapons. Thank you, good job. Okay? Nice. Nice, Maxwell. Yeah. That's hard to see, man. You put that in somebody's throat or chest, they're gonna have a hard time blocking that. You know? Stab them with it. Stab them with it. You know? Treat your elbow like the end of a staff. Stab them with it. Nice, Trish Bautista. It looks already cleaner. It looks cleaner already. Excellent. Nice, Pierre. I love the slow. Okay. Let's do that. Let's take a look at Pierre's screen right quick, guys. Let's look at Pierre's screen. Okay, see, Pierre now is breaking it down into micro movements, right? Look, aiming one elbow, aiming the other elbow, boom, then switching around, right? So you could go slow like this and stationary, no footwork. I'm fine with it because by the time you put it in pendulum, it's gonna look clean, right? So I'm okay with you just being stationary, no footwork, and just working on that, okay? But if you want a little bit more challenge, go ahead. Add the random flow and footwork. Good job, Pierre. Continue, guys. Good job. Let me know if there's any questions. Feel free to unmute yourself or type something in the chat. Play some music. Feel the movement. Okay. Nice, Bautista. All right, here's your addition. Now you're gonna throw first points, fists. You could strike, you could poke in the eye. However, what I want you to also do is like we did a few weeks ago, is you could punch with your hands either at 6 o'clock or at 12 o'clock. Now, if you do punch your fist at 6 o'clock, like this, that's what's a good time to also insert the elbow. Right after or right before, right? Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, nice, Trish Bautista. You can even go reverse where you catch it. It's coming in. You catch it with the elbow. As it pulls out, you do a back fist to it. You know what I mean? Yeah. This is you utilizing your arms as the buksai. This is you identifying your arms as like the buksai weapon. Okay. Now, I see if you can, whatever punch you throw, see if you can insert an elbow before or after in that same line, in the same direction that your punch is. So if your punch is towards 12 o'clock, your hands is towards 12 o'clock, then see if you can insert an elbow at 12 o'clock. If your punch is pointed at 6 o'clock, see if your elbow that comes right afterward is also is at 6 o'clock. Yeah, yeah, Bautista, exactly. Right, and you can do the opposite. You can do this. You punch this way. Right, so there's two ways. You can go boom, boom, or boom, boom. You can even go side. Right, boom, 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 boom. Hey, they want to pull out weapons. Questions? Nice, Pierre. Nice, Mateo. It's like, you know, that elbow sticks out, you know? It's like it's stabbing, you know? So it's, I like how you're like stretching it out and getting it out there. That's great. Ooh, all right, okay. I'm inspired by you, Joe. All right, here's an add-on. We're gonna do a quick add-on inspired by Joe. This is what I want you to guys do. After you slip, like earlier, we did an exercise where you slip and you let it go around, right? This one. Pierre, we're gonna do a quick add-on, okay? Remember earlier we did this exercise? You slip and you let it go around. Slip, let it go around, and you watched it. You look, and then you aim with your elbow. I mean, you aim with your shoulder. Remember, right? You slip, went around for it. Aim. Now, what I want you to try to do is, as soon as you slip, as it comes around, right? Before it crosses the line to for another pendulum, I want you to catch it on its way back with an elbow. Okay, with an elbow. So this way. Right? It's hard for me, right? But I want you to start training your eyes. Right? You're learning how to hit things as it goes around and passes you. Okay? And you stick your elbow to see if you could align it and hit the ball, or at least, okay? Good luck. Have fun. It will be the other elbow, Trish. So instead of chasing it with that same elbow, right? You go and then you wait for it to come. Yep. No, so you slip. It's a challenge. I don't know why. This is actually super high on that. So you slip, right? You slip with this elbow, right? And then it's gonna be this elbow. Okay? So the opposite elbow you slip with. Yeah, but this time, let it go around your head, right? You're switching your body. So for this one, right? Let's see. Remember that other exercise we did earlier when you let it go around from one shoulder to the other? Yeah. Okay. Nice, Joe. Nice. Excellent. So come at it at 6 o'clock, at 9 o'clock, at 3 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Move around your ball if you can, okay? If you can, move around your ball. And for you guys who's punching with your first point, with your fist, nice, Trish, that's it. Make sure that you're fully extended, okay? If you're going to be punching Punch with a largo fist, long range. Yeah, that one's hard. That one. Now try to hit it at the tip of your elbow, okay? Try to hit the tip with your elbow, Pierre. Nice. Excellent. Yeah, you're catching it from the back, on its way back. Okay, you're learning how to anticipate. Right? Now, what you want to start doing is arranging your angle at it. I mean, your range from it, right? Are you hitting it with the tip of your elbow, or are you hitting it with the back of your shoulder? Or are you hitting it with... Oh, I got hit. Okay, let you freestyle right here. Feel free to add on anything that's your flavor. Make sure you include some blocks and evasions so you're not always striking, that you could deflect, you could guide. So throw fists, throw elbows, throw shoulders. Just go all out right here. Excellent, Pierre. Guys, you guys look excellent. Beautiful. Okay, Maxwell, keep going, Maxwell. Everybody take a break. Let's look at Maxwell's screen right quick. Okay. So Maxwell is always keeping his target in front of him, right? And every time he steps back, his elbow or his shoulder is aimed at the ball, hyper-focused on the ball. Feeling the movement of the ball right there. He's slipping. Oh, nice catch on the way back, right? So that was a great demonstration of that technique. He went around it, and then he caught it on its way out. Okay, I want to open up the mics for other people to observe and make comments for about at least 30 seconds, encouraging you all to speak. You don't have to, but you can. I'm gonna unmute yourself. Go ahead.
Yeah, I saw this one again when he aligned it like that.
Yep. So clean, right?
I forgot about that. It looks nice. Yeah.
And that's one thing. Yeah, right there. He did it again. That's one thing about it. It's like really, it's geometry, guys. It's really just lines, right? It's like dancing. It's really just the lines. If you find your alignment, that's where you have the power, right? So for him to align both his arms like that, it's showing that there was alignment and his body is aligned with his strikes, right? It's easy to see because, like, you know, he's got an athletic thin build, so you could see him very sharp. It looks like his body type's like Maestro Sonny Umpat, you know, like skinny but slender and have long limbs, really expressive of the angles. Good job, sir. Keep it up, Maxwell. All right. Everybody take a quick break and grab your weapons. And then we'll do a quick review of anything that you have any questions with. And then grab a single stick. We'll keep the book side, okay? All right. Go ahead and do some warm-ups, doing your X patterns with corto, with medio, okay? And then if you get away with it, see if you can slide some largo. So just a reminder, again, usually this is done with a longer stick, but because of our constrictor, our space, we're gonna be using medio-sized sticks. You might have a corto, but try to use a medio to a largo, okay? So warm up with your basics, this one, or the 2X, remember the X, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Same thing with the medium, either palms down, X, or once is palm up. Okay? So then, the largo. Now the largo, if you do have the space, is the circular strikes in our system, okay? And you're super angled at it. Okay, but we won't focus on that today. But the buksai consists of all of those three. Today, 1 and 2, short, corto, and medio, medium, okay? So go ahead, just touch it, and then we're gonna do evasions and blocks. Okay. Now what we're gonna do is to spend the next 2 minutes working on our evasions and our blocks, okay? So no pressure attacking the ball. This is strictly guiding and deflecting the ball. Okay? So when you're doing the pendulum, just guide it. You can push it, but always guard up with a corto or medio. So I'm doing medio. I'm doing corto. Right? Once in a while, I'll catch it, I'll push it, I'll guide it somewhere else, right? But I don't want you really hitting it for the sake of hitting. I want you to quote block, right? And also evade with no touching, right? But guarding up, like have your stick in front of the ball, but you don't have to touch it, right? Excellent, Trish. Nice. Joe, move around the ball, okay? So that way you can learn how to hit a moving target while you're moving. Excellent. Okay. Nice. So let's do corto. Let's go back to corto for now. Let's all just do corto, okay? Meaning your hands are, so Trish Bautista was doing it. You're just here. You're not here. You're here. And remember, guys, always like Trish Bautista have it, have it in front of you, either this way or this way. There'll be a time where you could do it this, but this is a neutral stance. We don't ever want to just be like this, okay? We always want to be bladed, okay? However, that doesn't mean that you're not like this. This is a transition point. You can always transition from one place to this, but don't stand like this and square up, okay? Like this. Still point your elbows and your shoulders. Still point your shoulders, okay? Now, if you're comfortable, you could do what Maxwell is doing. You could start crossing. Okay, this. If you're not ready for that, then that's fine. Just work on your basic ones. Excellent, Trish. Good. Okay, here's your first add-on. Your first in the corto range, the first one is gonna be a jam. The second one is an angle strike, okay? So if it's coming at you, the first one is a jam. Either this or this, right? Where you're sticking the ball, okay? Try not to hit it downwards. You could, but it might rip your ball off, okay? So instead of hitting it downwards, maybe hit it away. Now, but do it lightly, because what you're gonna do is you're gonna do a follow-up strike. That one, in an angle. Okay, so you're gonna go jam. And those jams are coming in angles. Look, I'm coming either this way or this way, right? So I'm just jamming, and then as soon as I jam it, I punch it with an angle strike, right? Jam, punch. And then I let it go, and then I wait, and then I go again. Jam, punch. Nice, Pierre. Nice, Dimitri. Excellent, Maxwell. Good control, by the way. Because what the thing about this is, like, if you hit the ball and, you know, you want to have power in it, but once you hit the ball, it's going to start behaving, you know, agitated and bouncing and running from you. So what you really want to do is catch that first jab, and even though you're doing it with power, you're still doing it lightly, because you want to do is you want to come back for that second strike. Nice, Mac, Mateo, going in, coming in and coming out. You're doing it coming in and coming out. Great. Nice. Oh, that was nice. I love how you got closer with your footwork, you know? Okay, let's keep going. We're going to watch you, okay, Mateo? All right, let's take a quick 1 minute break. We're gonna watch Mateo for a second. We're gonna observe. I also would like you to make some observations if you see anything, okay? Okay, so turn on your mics if you see anything. I would like to start by saying earlier, what I like about Mateo, right there, he did it again. He's hopping on his footwork. He's like doing subtle footwork movement to get closer, right? Because it's a short stick. It's the shortest part of the stick, right there, right? So in order for you to get access to your ball while it goes away, you gotta kind of cheat your range. You gotta start getting towards it, right? So right here, he's keeping it in the angle. Good. Now he's doing it right, but that's a lot of great control, right? Feel free to make any observations if you see anything. Trish is joining us. Welcome to the Trish. Okay, he did it again there. It's hard to see because, you know, the camera's pointed up, but you could see it right there. He did it. You could see it when he does a little miniature hop right there. He did it again, right? That's him stealing range, right? That's him trying to, because he can't reach the ball with a short stick, with a short part of stick. So he's doing a footwork hop, okay? So I'd like you to experiment of stealing the range, getting closer to the ball through, I did it again, through your footwork. Good job, Mateo. So just come look at my screen for a second. Okay, so this is what I assume that Mateo is doing in order to steal the range, right? Because the camera's not pointed at. So he'll do this, he'll do this, he'll do that, he'll do this. And what that is the slight movement of the pendulum in neutral. Remember, this is your pendulum, right? Right? And he's doing this. He's basically shuffling, shifting, right? He is shifting off the foot, the balls of his feet. He's doing that. You could do it this way too. Okay? So, okay? Excellent job, Mateo. Okay. Let's get back to work. Here's an addition. We did this last week. Out of the jam, that one. You're jamming it. After you jam it, you kind of hold it for fulcrum. And then you release it. It's like a, what do you call that? Slingshot. It's like a slingshot. Boom. Okay? Now try to do it light because you might kill your ball, and that's okay. Boom, same angle. Okay, slingshot. Yes, yes, work on it, work on it. That should take you forever. Okay, catch it with the butt. Remember, two strikes, puño first with a jam, jam, boom, jam, boom. Jam, boom. Okay, after you jam it, you throw a slingshot at it as it goes away. Okay? Let me know if you have any questions. Nice, Joe. Nice. Now try to get close to hitting it with the tip of your stick, guys. But I don't mind as long as you hit it. Now you gotta set it up for the slingshot. As soon as you hit a jam, like be in that ready mode to let the tip go. And boom, be in that ready mode. And then use the tip of your stick as soon as you hit it, gun like a gun sight. You know, as soon as you aim it with the butt, that's the same angle with the tip. Look, as soon as I aim it with this, right? As soon as I aim it, I know that this is coming next. So really what I'm doing is I'm just, as soon as I do that, I'm just letting this part touch, but I'm using my hand to kind of like resist it, right? So meaning once you do this initial jam, you should already be aimed, right? This initial jam, the tip, you should already be thinking about the tip going. So as soon as you jam it, you kind of guide it. This is like you looking at the barrel of a gun, right? This part is the tip of the gun. So you're like, boom, and you're like, boom. Right? You go, boom, and you go, boom. Right? So this is someone attacking you, and you're using the jam to hit them in the wrist, or maybe hit his weapon away, right? And as soon as you hit this weapon away, you come right back. right? So you're letting the action of the gem initiate and release and fire this one, right? Boom, boom. Okay, two strikes. Nice, Trish. Nice, Joe. Nice. Okay, now you're going to try to hit it three times, but this time you're going to come back right after that tirador, that slingshot. As soon as your hand comes back, it's gonna release a medio going upwards this time. Okay, so you're gonna go jam, slingshot, upward strike. Okay, that upward can be a block too. He's trying to attack you again. You block and then you get to the eyes. Okay, boom. You poke him in the eyes right afterwards. Okay, so you go jam, slingshot on the way back. You get it out of the way, right? Upwards, the upwards part of the X, okay? Leverage is here. Look at the leverage right here, right? Boom, but going that way. It's in the center of my body, okay? Now, from here, poke the ball. You're poking at the eye. So you go, boom, and then poke at medium range, okay? So you're going to go, you gave a lot. I said, jam, slingshot. Upward strike, and then poke it one more time if you could do it, right? But basically now you're like here. Now you're like this. Because you go boom, and then you bring it back, and you poke, okay? Now, if it's too much, just stay on your ones and twos, and that's totally fine. Nice, Pierre, yes. Yes, and you don't have to, Pierre. But that one's going X, the upward part of the X, this one. So you go, boom, boom, boom. All right. And then once there's clearance, you can see the eyes, then you go for the eyes. All right, so you go jam, slingshot, upward strike. Poke at the eyes. You could all do that at the same space, or you could be moving your footwork at each strike. Okay, experiment. You're learning how to go single-handed on your stick, and you're learning how to go double-handed on your stick. You're becoming more dynamic with your stick. You're not being married to just holding it a certain way. You're learning how to be dynamic, switching hands, switching leverage points, right? You need to learn how to grab it tight so you don't get disarmed. But you also know how to learn how to grab it very loosely so you could shuffle it around and react at the very microsecond of your opponent's movement, or in this case, the ball's movement. All right, we're gonna go another maybe 10, 15 minutes. Let me know if you have any questions. This is gonna clean up your hyper-focus even more, because now you're poking. You're doing a slingshot. You're going upwards, you know, and you're trying to move your feet, okay? So remember your basics with the way you hold the hand, your sticks, lock your fingers, but keep them loose, but keep them locked. I want you to experiment that every time you do one of those 3-4 shot combinations, that you're at a different place of, on the floor, right? You're always moving. Your first strike is at one place of the floor. Your second strike is at your second place of the floor, et cetera, right? So you're always moving at every strike. All right, this is where we're gonna insert our largo. Now, instead of that poke after the slingshot or the upward, the what is that? 6, 7, 8, 9, angle 9, upward angle 9. Instead of the poke, so you're gonna go jam, slingshot, upward strike from here, right? After you do this, you're gonna switch your hands. You're gonna go, boom, and you're gonna go this way. And this hand is gonna do a subtle switch. And from here, you're gonna do a long shot. Right? So it's gonna be from your left hand. You're shooting from your left hand, right? So you're going jam, slingshot, right? From here, you're gonna bring it back and you're gonna do an upward strike. Right? From here, you're gonna do this subtle hand placement switch. See, this is what I'm doing. I'm going like this, and all I'm doing is this. That's actually over-exaggerated. What I'm really doing is this and this. Okay? This and this. Now, I'm over-exaggerating so you could see it. I'm gonna go strike angle 9, right? And then I go like this. From here, I release a lot of go from my left hand, right? Because ideally, this was my right hand, I jam, I do a slingshot, that's my right hand, right? And then I sweep it back, that's still my right side, everything right is pointed. And then I do the subtle hand change, right? And then I step out, and that's my left hand coming down, right? And that's a circular, diagonal, vertical to diagonal strike. That is when I'm fully extended a lot of range. Right, so I'm going, and you're catching your opponent al corto, you're backing them up by doing a slingshot, and you're going medio, you're doing it again, as you step out, you're going medio, and then now, you are pivoting, I'm pivoting, as I switch hands, and I'm doing a long range. I'm being furthest away from my opponent while I'm striking him. I'm moving myself away from danger. At the same time, I'm striking, and on my way out from danger, I'm still striking. Okay, one more time. Now you can do it with your right or your left, but if you do it with your left, then that means your strike is gonna, largo is gonna end up with your right, right? You're gonna go boom, 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 wow. Okay, and then another thing what I do, guys, is when I'm doing that switch, that hand placement, I'm gonna do this, right? Maybe I don't do the hand placement. So, cause you can even do it like this. You can even do the angle 9 with both palms down, and that way your hand's already like this. So instead of having the palm up, and instead of having a switch, you can also go pop both palm up. That way you don't have a switch. Now for me, I got used to it already, so it doesn't matter, I could just switch. But then since you're working on it still, you're new to it, then you could end up with both palm down. So when you do transition into the largo, the hand is already in place. Now, what makes it successful for me is when I retract my stick, I bring it around. Remember when we did this exercise? I bring it around my shoulders. I go left shoulder, right shoulder, and then largo. Okay? Okay, so I'm going boom. Nice, Joe. That's it, Joe. Nice, exactly. Excellent. Now, Joe, experiment when you do the last one, wrapping it around your head, right? After this one, and you switch this one, wrap it around your head, right? Yeah, so you have both. You don't have to wrap it around your head and strike in front of you, and then, or you can wrap it around your head and strike, let it come from behind you. Nice, perfect, just like that. Yeah, Pierre. And you see where weapon is going after that, Pierre? How it goes to your hip? Yeah, now it goes to your hip. Now it's like hidden, ready for the next thing. Yes. Okay, so we're starting to play with the idea of hand switching with the Buksai. That's what we're doing right now. You're learning how to, you're already doing it unconsciously with this activity, but now you're starting to do it more intentionally, right? You're learning how to switch and rotate hands. We want to start building your being ambidextrous, being left-handed and right-handed. Okay, but that's going to take some time, okay? That's you just continuing. Yeah, Joe, you killed it. That's you just continuing to practice, okay? Anybody, any of you can be as accurate, even more accurate than me, okay? All you need to do is put on some mileage and some time on this, yeah? All right, you guys are looking amazing. I'm going to go around the room, okay? And then we're going to end it with some freestyle where you can just kind of develop your own technique. Right now, I'm showing you one of my techniques. I want you to be inspired by it, to do your own techniques, and put your own combinations together, which you were already doing, by the way. You're not doing nothing new. You've been doing this. I'm just kind of like helping you identify your movements. Yeah. Try to aim for the tip, Trish. When you release tirador strike, that slingshot strike, right?
I'm just trying to figure out when we grab after the puño here, then the largo. Do you step in for this or?
Good question. Yeah,
you kind of figure it out for the sway of the ball.
Yeah, right? So it's really about
as it's going out. I'm stepping back as it comes to me.
Right.
And then what was that? I'm just trying to figure out like how it all comes together with a sway.
Right. Yeah. So adjust accordingly, right? If it's going out, then you might have a step forward, right? But if it's coming in, then you might have a step backward, right? Earlier I was watching Joe, and her ball was kind of like swinging a really tiny bit, and what she was focusing was adjusting her body to the ball, right? So play around with it. So in the initial stages, boom, boom. Here I'm actually in the same range, Trish. I haven't moved in or out yet, right? But for you, just play with it and see what works at the time, right? All right, where are we? So that means, Bautista, that means you may have to step away from it instead of stepping forward, you know what I mean? Like Joe, if you watch Joe, what she's doing is she's stepping away from the largo right here, right? She steps away from it to do her power right there, like right there in medio, and then she steps away from the ball, right? So maybe experiment with that. Nice, Mateo. Okay. So welcome, Trish Ong. What we were doing is we started doing a combination of jamming, right? Either coming in or coming out, and then we'll jam it. And then from the jam, we'll release like a theater door strike, which is like a slingshot strike. From here, we go like that. We use the fulcrum from the base of the stick, and we go jam, then like a slingshot, right? We're using this to accelerate a fulcrum for a slingshot strike. Jam, slingshot strike, okay? After the slingshot strike, we do an upward strike like this, okay? And then after that, we do a largo strike. We're just putting in combinations that has all of the ranges, which you guys already been doing, right? But right now we're doing a specific technique that has the ranges, right? Again, it's jam, right? When it comes in or out, and then release that one, right? Jam, release it, then that one, okay? From that one, it goes long range. This is a set of combinations. Now, I like what you're doing there, Mateo. That last one, bro, that's a largo. So that's actually what you just did. Whack, like a real, yeah, that's a power. Like that's for the guy that's running at you and he's kind of drunk. That's what you got to do to those kind of guys. You got to step away and give him the tip of your largo. You don't want to wrestle with those guys. If they're inebriated, if they're high, if they're super drunk, if they're hyphy, you want to be able to step out and give the long tip. And you wanna be able to range yourself away from crazy dudes. Because sometimes when someone is inebriated or extra, you hit them, they'll still keep coming, right? So giving them the long first. Long, and then you get ready for the medium and the short ranges. Excellent, guys. You guys are looking amazing. We're gonna be wrapping up soon. I want you to start thinking about some questions that you might have. You know, anything around transitions, anything around the range, anything around the hand switching, okay? We're starting to experiment with getting into hand switching. But really, we want to build good habits with hand switching because we can get disarmed or we can get hurt, right? So intentional with our hand switching. Hey, looking great. And now we're gonna let go of this pattern and we're gonna start to freestyle. But what I'd like you to do, focusing on this particular freestyle session that we're gonna do, is when you are striking, I want you to see where you can insert your largo, but I also want you to do what we did last week, okay? I want you to be able to utilize your stick and touch it at both tips, even if that means crossing. But go slow. I want you to, really what I want you to do is this, guys. We'll take a look for a second. I want you to be able to strike and learn how to do your switches, okay? So again, I'm over-exaggerating. I don't want you to do it this big. I want you to do it more subtle, okay? But when you're switching, right, remember one hand at a time. After one hand switches, you know, let's say I'm gonna do this strike, right? And I don't have, so that strike, but I wanna do both palms, right? So I wanna do this, both palms down. Right now, one palm is up and one palm is down, right? But I hit it with a corto and I wanna do that, but both palms down. So what I do is after I hit it, I switch here, right? And then I let that go. So meaning start playing around and be more expressive in your hand switches when you're doing this drill exercise. Okay? Right? Start really expressing your hand manipulations and switches. And then once in a while, hit it at a largo range. Because right now you're doing corto and medio, and we're doing that. You're doing this extremely complicated stuff, right? And then once in a while, step out. Or when the ball is going away, step in. And get it a largo, a long range strike when you're only touching it with one hand. Okay? Have fun. We'll do for 5 minutes and then we'll close out. Freestyle, come up with your own. Okay? Imagine some are blocks and some are strikes. Okay? If your ball is weighted and it has a strong connection, put some pressure a little bit on your largo strikes. Not so much with your corto or your medio. Joe, that's a great shirt, by the way. Nice. Nice, Bautista. Excellent. I like that. Keep going, Trish Ong. Keep going. Let's just take a quick 1 minute review. Let's review Trish Ong's screen, everybody. So take a quick break, and we're going to review Trish. Wait, speaker view, and this one. Okay. Okay, she's identifying. There's a close range, right? Close range, and then look. Look at that largo. Look how wide and circular that is. Okay? So in your corto and medio, you're kind of more angled. You're more boxy. And then look at the largo, right? Stepping out, circular, wide. That's your longest range. Being able to play with all of those three ranges. You see how she steps back, and you see when the ball is going away from her, she steps in, right? So she's adjusting her range to the ball. Does anyone else want to make any reviews or comments? Please unmute yourself and feel free to review or say something. Right, those are more medium. Okay, she's still stepping. There's a largo. And you could tell from the medium strikes from the largo strikes. Because the medium strikes are more angled. She's more scared. That's a medium. That's short. Medium. Largo right there. Okay. Excellent job, Trish Ong. All right, everybody back to work before we wrap up. Good job. Let's go 4 minutes. Roll your whole energy. I want you to sweat. I want you to be working on your accuracy. And you guys, oh my God, I love to actually make a video with you guys. Instead of just this footage, I would love for you to kind of like film yourself with your phone and maybe send it to me. And I'd like to cut some videos together. It won't be soon, but if whenever you can, that would be great. And you know, your accuracy, man, I like to document it. You know, what week are we doing this? I'd really like to see it in you know, like 6-8 weeks from now. I'd like to see it. I'd like to see it 4 weeks from now and how cleaner you got. Because if you've seen yourself the first time we were doing it to now, man, you guys are like samurais. All right, I'm gonna flow with Joe. Excellent movement, guys. Someone went Heisey right now. Were there cars? Okay, I'm gonna film a little bit. Excellent. Nice, Pierre. Nice, Dimitri. Okay, 2 minutes, 1 minute, 2 minutes, actually. Excellent. Now, if you're engaging your medio strikes, make sure your elbows, your shoulders are pointed as well, okay? Make sure you're staying bladed, keeping the body bladed. Hey, last minute, go all out. Nice. Oh man, Maxwell, that's killer, loving it. Trish, your angulation, man, that's what's up. Like, really expressing that largo and showing it with your body, you know, like showing that long range with your body. It's really good, nice to see, because it's the lines of the largo. It's you could tell when it's fully extended. Wonderful job, ladies and gents. All right, let's start slowing it down. Let's eventually bring your pendulum to a still when you're ready, but go ahead. Good job, guys. Love the footwork. Very impressive, keep it up. Don't get stale and not work on your angulation. Just because we're not doing the shoulder exercise doesn't mean you don't point the shoulder, right? Still continue with those foundations, all right? All right, let's get together, let's circle up, and then just kind of like a quick circle of how people are feeling, what they're walking away with today. And then let's close out with a salute. And thank you again, you guys are amazing. Your freestyle and your ability to follow patterns and be disciplined and listening to what I ask. I really appreciate that. And then seeing your ability to freestyle and put your own flavor on it. That's inspiring for me. It kind of continues to give me more ideas. So sometimes I come here with a plan, but sometimes I'm just like, I come in with an intention to allow the growth to happen organically based on what we're seeing and what we're doing together, you know? And it's nice, it's really nice, right? I don't wanna praise you too much, because if I praise you too much, I feel like I might lose you in terms of your dedication or your working on your refinement, right? So I wanna tell you, you are all right. But in reality, I felt like you were doing really great. So keep up the good work, all right? Let's just go up in a circle, let's do a quick, some acknowledgement that you might have a realized or aha moment or what you want to appreciate, anything like that. And then let's go in a circle. I could go first. I just appreciate you guys giving me more inspiration. You know, like I said, sometimes I come with a plan and sometimes I don't know what to plan, you know, but I want to work on progress. I want you to be progressing so you don't feel like you're repeating the things. And so I just want to appreciate you for teaching me, because I get to learn, you know, and I get to be a student by me watching you. And then when I get inspired by you or by one of you and sharing that, I love it because it feels like we're building, we're learning as a community. I want to make, I would like to, one thing I do like to critique myself with, I like to make more time with building and reviewing each other and then opening up the space for other people to talk, right? And I appreciate you, Trish Bautista, for hopping in and giving your insights. I think it's really cool that, because you're an experienced martial artist, but I also want to invite non-experienced martial artists to, you know, to speak. And I know Pierre and Dimitri speaks a different language, but I also want to invite you to give us feedback and critique us, or just see, just mention things that are good. And you can even type on the chat. You can go chat and you could say, I like it. For example, like, I like the flow. You know, I want to create a space where everybody feel like that they get, they can, they're creating, they're learning, and they're getting to contribute, right? Cool, that was my input. Anyone else would like to go? I'd like to choose the graduate, Maxwell. Happy graduation, class of 2020. You're special. I love you. You may go.
Thank you. So I thought that, especially today or this class, for some reason, I guess something clicked, but I was trying to integrate more of the hand-to-hand stuff that we were learning into the weapon flow. And so I started to kind of experiment with that and try to like figure out new ways to integrate my elbows and my fists with the weapon.
Awesome observation, man. Be the weapon, yeah? And earlier, our earlier activity when we were like, hey, hit it with your elbow, hit it with your fist, right? That's you using your arms as the buksai, right? This is my short, my medium, my long, you know? So, and then what Maxwell talking about, even in the elbow, like you got a stick, insert the elbow and then tip. Now you have a plethora. I don't even know what that word means. I'm thinking it's a lot. But a plethora of angles, my friend. Good job, Maxwell. And again, congratulations. And if you don't follow Maxwell, or at least Carlo, Maxwell's dad, super proud family, graduated. And man, I love your graduation videos, by the way. He's just like doing everything at the house with the family. Made me realize how really special this class is, you know, or this time is, because it makes people be with their strongest, closest bonds, you know. So I love seeing you and celebrating your joy and your family's joy. Same with Mateo, graduated to ninth grade, right? Ninth grade? Okay, Grandpa. Okay. All right. Go ahead, Max. Who would you like to choose next?
You go Dimitri.
You mute, my brother. I'll mute you. Dimitri, I cannot hear you. Microphone. Excellent.
You understand?
No. Go ahead, speak.
Okay. Alors, in first, I wanted to thanks again for the class. Because it's very interesting. And my point is interesting for now is the corto. Because I don't know the corto with the stick. And very interesting for that. And I wanted to improve that.
Mm. Excellent.
And now I am interested for the transition always for the largo and medio and corto. You understand with the stick? Huh? It's very, very interesting, and I must work that.
Okay, excellent. Good to know. Thank you so much, Dimitri. Anything else?
Just in the transition, same for the empty hand with the elbow, shoulders, and punch. It's very, very interesting. Very nice.
And from what I understand from your culture, interesting means it's cool, right? Excellent. Well, damn, interesting. What does that mean? But thank you, my brother. Continue to work on what you think you want to work on, right? And what's cool is you are actually in the doorway. Your setup is in the doorway. Perfect for corto, right? Perfect for corto. Work on your corto. That's what you got. And it looks so good with you because you're like, you do Wing Chun and you do, you know, so you really know how to close the range. So just put it together and have fun. Had fun with it. Okay?
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Salam, Dimitri. Who would you like to go next, my friend?
Joe.
Excellent.
I think today I really feel more just in tune. I feel like I've listened to the last, I wasn't in the last class, but the class before, I was listening to some of the feedback then and feedback that I was receiving from myself. And during this class, I felt myself more loose and more just moving, not going for trying to hit everything, but more so like really just connecting with the ball. I had like pent up tension before, and not to say that it's not there, but I feel like I've been letting a lot of things go, and now when I'm working with the ball, I'm really flowing more. So that feels really good, and I'm just excited to do more.
Excellent. Excellent. You're moving really phenomenal today. Thank you so much for giving yourself the permission to express yourself. And it inspired me, obviously. I know we watched you for a second and you were like, no, don't watch me. But I felt like that was a good thing. I think it was great. It was encouraging for you and it was encouraging for us. And to see your growth is amazing. So thank you so much for growing with us, not just as martial artists, but emotionally and spiritually, because that's what this martial art is for us, you know? So thank you so much again and for sharing and learning and telling us your journey. Yeah? Salamat. Who would you like to go next?
Let's go with Mateo.
So I think everyone, like just looking at everyone really, like I said that again, I'm saying this again, it helps. And since everyone looks so good, like their accuracy is great, everyone's learning, it makes me feel like I'm behind and I need to keep on pushing myself to be either better or at my best. Mm. And that's just inspiring for me to watch everyone else and then telling myself that I need to start getting better.
Thank you, Mateo. Is there anything else?
No, nothing else.
I'm always looking forward to you and your brother's input. You guys got so much wisdom. That's why when as soon as your mic, I smile. When you and your brother start to talk, I'm like, okay, what are they going to say? You know? And you guys capture so much from behind the scenes, and I really appreciate that. And I think this is like, it's kind of like golf, you know, where the person you're really competing with is yourself. You know, like, yeah, it looks like, look at everybody moving, but it's not even a competition. It's really just the one you're dealing with is yourself and this ball, right? So that's fine to feel like that, Mateo. Why? Because it keeps you on your toes. It keeps you edged. It keeps you bladed to feel like I don't want to fall behind, right? So we want every single body to feel that way. And I remember the reason we started reviewing each other and including that in our pedagogy and the way we teach is because what you said, you know, like, hey, it's tight when we're watching each other. So I was like, yo, let's do that, right? So you're right. And I love how you're giving everybody props and props to everybody because you guys are looking better. But don't give them too much props, okay? Because I want them to continue to refine themselves. So great job, Mateo. But as a younger warrior in the system, and we are intergenerational group, I really appreciate you giving those insights, okay? So salama to you and your brother. Mateo, who would you like next?
Pierre.
Yeah.
Okay. So thank you for your teaching first.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Very nice. I like a lot.
Oh, you love it. Good. Not just interest.
Yes, okay. I love that. And yes, I like the transition. It's very, very nice. And the flow for me, I like Visayan for that, the flow and the transition. And it's a little bit one discovery, the long.
Yeah, Largo.
Largo. Yes, mm-hmm. Largo. For me, yeah. I know a little bit, but no like that. So it's very nice.
Good.
And I like because all class, you have the continuity, no?
Yeah.
And it's fantastic.
Oh, blessings to you, sir. Great. Thank you so much for sharing. Continuity is good because I want us to get better and I want to be a better instructor. And part of that is I can easily be lazy and just not watch ourselves and not improve. But hola, baby. But I wanted to make sure that we're building, right? I do have a question for you. I would like to ask, when you say transition, what specifically do you mean by the transition that you like about our system? Or, you know, like, is there a specific transition or
No, it's a transition on the distance.
Oh, range. Yeah.
Awesome. Medio, largo, and yes.
Yeah.
For me now, the difficulty, it will be Winchun and Eskrima yeah. because it's similar, but it's opposite. No, Winchun is very
rigid in the front, right there. Yeah. So remember.
Yes, for me it's my job now, but I like this this way too.
Yeah, angle. Yeah. So yes, angle is thank you for that. You know,
thank you too.
We're learning. Yeah, thank you, sir. We're learning the transitions for sure, right? And we haven't really got the focus down. I love all the babies coming around. Well, man, big buck.
Dominic.
What's up, Handsome? Thank you for hanging out with us for a little bit.
He said he wants to learn a little, so I might teach him a little bit.
Excellent. I hope you learn and come back and come and visit us next week, okay? And learn with us, okay? But pick it up from moms. Moms knows what's up.
This is auntie.
Pick it up from auntie. Pick it up from auntie. You know, auntie knows what's up. Thank you so much for being here.
Bye.
Bye. Feel free to listen in, okay? This is the part where we're just talking. It might be boring for you, but you're more than welcome to be part of it, okay? Pierre, thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And remember, it's only difficult if you're between Eskrima and Wing Chun if you hold on to the tradition, right? But if you let go of that part, you could blend it.
Yeah.
It could be one, right? All you're doing is transitioning from close range, medium range, to long range.
Yes.
Yeah? And really that's it. Mm-hmm. So just let go of the preconceptions of what short range should be based on one martial art, right? Because Filipino martial arts also have the close range and we also fight for the center line, but we don't have to also. We also give the center line up. So just kind of blend it, you know, but have fun in your journey. That's a good journey to be in.
I have a lot of fun.
Yeah. Oh, man, I love watching you move, Pierre. I really be like, look at this white boy from Switzerland moving like that. Man, that's pretty tight. So I'm really appreciative of your movement, okay?
Yeah, and thank you so much
for being graceful in the way you could take our art form, okay? Thank you. Who's next, my friend Pierre? Who would you like to choose?
Excuse me.
I think both the Trishas haven't gone yet. Trisha Ong and Patricia Bautista have not gone yet.
Patricia?
See, which one? There's two. We have two Patricias.
Excuse me. Bautista.
Uh-huh. Excellent.
Bautista.
So for me, I had just three different learnings or insights. Just the idea of adding these ones to my roster because I'm used to just doing the lower attacks with the bunksai. I don't quite know how to do this. They're just refining the upward kind of hand switches also because I'm used to lining it with the hips. Because it feels comfortable, but I need to get comfortable with the ones up here.
Yeah. Can you repeat the parts that you're having trouble with again? Because there's some sounds.
Oh, sorry about that. You know, with the bunksai, I feel comfortable with this because it feels natural.
Yep.
For the one
upward.
When you go upward, I'm like, oh, what am I doing? Is this really powerful? Like, yeah. I need to fix my alignment.
Right.
Because I just need that self-awareness of like, oh, is this, am I moving my hip? Am I just doing this properly?
Yes.
So that's my insight that I need to work on that. That's one. Another one is that in small space, it's like super small. I feel like my cargo is scrunched up.
Yeah, it is.
So I think it's a matter of waiting when the ball is kind of away before allowing, giving my, making that space for myself within a small environment. Hmm. So I can't do largo when it's over here close to me.
Nope.
I can't do it when it's away, you know? So just calculating my space and where I sit in a space. That was the second one. And the third was, I don't know if it was because I was thinking too much about it, but I felt like my ball was like extra rebellious today because it kept encircling instead of going
here.
And I'm like, what is up with this? So I don't know if it's the way I was hitting it or if it's the wind or whatever, but just understanding the nature of the ball right now, because
it looked like the wind. It looked like the wind for me. Yeah, because I saw it. I was like, huh. It's fluttering. Remember we had this issue in the first week? And it was like, her ball was like a butterfly. It was like.
So, trying to figure it out because it's not pendulum-ing, it's stirring. Yeah.
And then these have the same setup? Did you guys bring it lower still?
Yeah, it was the same as last week, but I don't know why it changed.
It's probably more windy today, I'm assuming. And then I don't know if being weighing it down more would help, but yeah, you definitely gotta adjust, right? And I think that's what's cool about FMA in general and this system and what we're doing. It's like you gotta adjust, right? I like how you saw it. It's like, yo, I can't do largo all the way back here. I gotta go here in order to execute. But that means you have to find the right timing to execute the largo, right? Because that means you won't be able to execute it all the time.
And I only have two angles where I can actually do any sort of largo, and
right.
the door over here.
Yeah.
Plants, things.
Yeah, totally. Similar with Mateo set up, his bed is right next to it. So it's like he can't do 9 o'clock. You know, he can only do 6, 3, and 12. You know, he's like, I can't do it. My bed's right there. Right. So adjust accordingly. Right. Again, you have more challenges because there's different elements. You have a short space and you only have 6 and 12. And you have the wind hitting your ball, right? So yeah, there's gonna be some more challenges for you. But again, I was mentioning to this because Trish had me teaching the Escabo class last night, invited me, and there was like 20 students, and I appreciate you, Trish, for having me there. And one of the things that we talked about was her skill actually accelerated faster because she had to deal with those elements with her pendulum ball. So when she got to us with fourth week, like I would just watch Trish Bautista's flow and accuracy and her ability to be patient. Her timing was a lot more better, right? So
I still feel like Mateo though, that I have to catch up to everyone.
That's good. But you know what? That's what's going to make you and Mateo sharper than everybody, because you guys have that drive to make yourselves better, right? So that's okay. Have that idea, because now you're going to keep yourself edged, bladed, and keep yourself on the edge. Like, you know what? I want to get better. I got to get better, right? So the last two things, I can't really do anything about it, but you already know the solution. You got to adjust your angle, or you got to be in a different space, right? Or you practice at a different location where you're expressing your largo, right? The first question I could help you with, the one about this one, the upper one, right? Just when you did the lower ones, I already saw there was no leverage. So just like you do the downward ones, when there's leverage, that means the lower one, you need to have that same fulcrum leverage. I mean, now my accuracy needs to work, right? So what you really got to work on is that rowing part. Just like the strength and the leverage you do on the lower ones, the ones and twos. When you do the seven and nines, right, you got to bring your hip with it. You got to lever, right? Like when you're rowing a boat, you don't just do this. You got to kind of like bring your hip, right? Right? You got to kind of like, when you're, oh, that looks weird. When you're rowing the boat, the work, the middle, wait a minute, where's my mind going? But the idea is there's this leverage that goes, I'm going to stop these movements, guys. Anyway, but the idea of using this, you're like a ride horse, ride the white horse. Sorry, that was wrong. But this idea of driving it up with the hips and this as a leverage of fulcrum points. Right? So yeah, practice on work on that. And maybe just do a few sessions by yourself where you're just working on your upward strikes. Right? We're working on that. Okay? Great. Any other thing, Trish? Bautista? No? Okay. Thank you for your patience, for continuing to train with us, even though you have to deal with those elements, right? And I think it shows in your passion and your drive to learn our system is regardless of those elements, you're like, yo, I'm gonna continue to work with it, all right? So thank you for that. Cool. Trish Ong, would you like to close us out? Did everybody got to speak?
Hi, everyone. Sorry I got here late, but thank you for having me. And thanks, Joe, for your compliment. But I'm still going to work hard to make it right. Because you know what? Like, my accuracy really fucking sucks with the largo. So, but
excellent. Yeah.
But yeah, and even the medio, like trying, like the switching hands and like needing to do it with the left hand. Yeah, I need to work on that. But I do like the largo because it feels like practical too for somebody as small as me. And yeah, to protect myself. Yeah, I don't know if Dimitri and Pierre, if you're getting U.S. news right now, but our country is burning up, and definitely feeling this morning like this different kind of focus, need to transform a lot of this like anger and rage. And yeah, you know, it's like, it's 400 years old. But it's very acute at the moment. So yeah, I just appreciate that, Jay, you continue to hold this space for us to learn our ancestral ways of protecting ourselves and being strong. And even if, you know, hopefully we never have to use it, but that it cultivates like a really strong mind and spirit so that we can be really clear and effective in other ways that we know how to fight. So, yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Trish, for coming. This place is always welcoming for you. I don't care anybody who you come in the last 5 minutes, last 1 minute, you know, can help us continue to create the space, not really tripping about what people could contribute, just keep it happening, right? And Trish mentioned something that's really traumatic for a lot of us, you know, especially people living in the United States, people of color, especially, or communities of color and Black folks that's being murdered by abusive police brutality, right? That you guys might be hearing about, especially during the pandemic. But, and it's showing more, a lot of, it's showing the history of oppression, and racism and all of the ugly parts of it, right? So, but guess what? And this is not to go out to anybody else, right? This is just for my, because I've had a lot of struggles with this emotionally as well, right? Because I come from a law enforcement background family, but I'm also come from urban East Oakland, Compton, NWA, fuck the police type attitude. But I'm also an educator and I have brown and black kids as my students. So I have a lot of mixed emotions. The martial arts gives me an outlet. Okay. And use the martial arts as an outlet. And I want to see that because it's a medicinal for me. And I'd like it to be medicinal for you. That if we have to use the martial arts to defend our people and our community, then we need to do it, right? If we have to protect our families, then we have to do it. But like Trish said, we use this to train our minds as well, okay? Here's another a challenge and reminder for all of you, particularly for the people that looks like me. Your ancestors have gone through so much more worse stuff. They've been lynched, they've been killed, they've been burned alive, right? So when we train the martial arts, try to have fun, of course, and lose yourself in the focus and the flow, of course, but also like channel your ancestors, you know? Channel those struggles, because that's what's gonna give you more juice to deal with the ugliness of the world, right? Like step on the shoulders of your elders and your ancestors, so they didn't pass away in vain, right? And use their struggles to build your struggle, right? To strengthen your struggle and make your struggle more beautiful, right? Because struggle is going to be part of life, but you got to ease it a little bit and make it a little bit more digestible, palatable, and that's our role as individuals in this world, to beautify a little bit. Okay, so sometimes we join protests, sometimes we just stay at home to protect our families, and that's all fine too, okay? So you do your part, okay? And then when you struggle, then you can, and then let the martial arts be one of your outlets, right? If you fucking going through some shit, let the martial arts be a way to release, all right? And if you're feeling down, then maybe one thing that's cool about this martial art is connected to our peoples. Then and reach deep within, and collect all of the lifetimes before you of your ancestors and your elders, and build a really strong and long largo stick. And use that, okay, and be a model for the younger people, because they're going to be the Mateos and the Macuas, they're going to be running the world, right? And they're going to know what the struggles are, and they're going to know what their ancestors have gone through. So model for them, so they can, because they already know, they're smart, right? So they can help shape our future, right? It's not going to go overnight. We're molasses compared to the times of dinosaurs, of trees, of the planet. It's super old. We're hella young. So we're still going through hella changes as humans. We still don't know how to love each other. So we got to model and work through it. Okay? We can't rush it. I want to rush it. I fucking want to beat motherfuckers in the head. And be like, yo, you're abusing our people. But only love can do that, right? And love and time. So we just got to deal with it and deal with our part and see what we can control and affect the people that we can control, right? And live our lives the way that could be mirrored by other people's, you know. Other than that, thank you for sharing, Trish, and being open and being vulnerable and connecting. Everything is related, you know, everything is related. So this is related. Our martial arts is related to what's happening to in the world. Okay. So use your martial arts to fight for what's right. Right. Without necessarily having to hurt anybody. Yet, unless you have to. All right, use your martial arts as your last, your first, the way you think, but your last, and if you have to apply any physical danger to other people, right? So thank you again for sharing. If there's any other last things, I want to appreciate you for making time for us, utilizing the martial arts as a way to, as an outlet, you know, whether you just want to sweat, whether you want to channel your ancestors, or whether you just want to hit something to get something out. All right. Thank you so much. I'd like to do a saludo. I really appreciate you as my community, as my students, but also as my teachers for teaching me. And I hope we can learn from each other. And I hope we don't have to use it. If we do, I'm going to be like Mateo. I'm going to be like Patricia Bautista. I'm going to continue to work on myself and get myself sharp and better. All right? Continue to work on yourself. Get yourself sharp and better. Keep yourself healthy. Socially connect. Physically distance at the moment. All right? Thank you so much. Maraming salamat. Thank you. Salamat po, guys. All right, let's do a quick screenshot while I have you there. While I have you there, one more picture, and I'm going to let you go. Ready? One more picture. One more picture. All right. Have a good one, y'all. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Salama.
Bye.
Bye, y'all.
Bye, everyone.
Salamat. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.